today's adventure is visiting the Insecure set for season 3. We're going to try and get some spoilers, probably not, but we're going to talk to the cast, get some wardrobe. Wardrobe department for Insecure. Slime Molly, Kelly, some Tro over there.
Just staying very true to that character and how they would typically dress, or typically how they dress separate of their own personality as well.
These characters already have a really defined sense of style. Like, I think that you can see them and say that feels very Issa or that feels very Molly.
Black designers, multicultural designers with new aesthetics and using very beautiful textiles, textures, colors, and integrating all that into the show, I think is really important. And Shiona does a beautiful job of doing that kind of seamlessly, which is someone kind of difficult to do, kind of coming in mid-season. But she's done a really great job.
The directors that we've had have been fortunate enough to let me improvise, which is a huge part of my background. I remember that day we were at the Malibu house, and we just kept doing the scene. And for me, like, the just because I come from doing stage, like, you perform, if you do the same thing over and over again, you're like, the audience is gonna go to sleep. So I was like, let me just start off. And they're like, oh, we're gonna keep that.
Nobody else, it's just us.
I'll say it's a good time to be a black woman.
It is. To be a black creative.
Be a black creative.
Obviously, yeah. There are black people out there killing it. You got your Avis, you have your Childish Gambino / Donald Glovers, you have everything Kenya Barris is doing. There's so many people who are working and, like, doing good work. There's so much good content that we don't, like, my DVR is full. I grew up when my mom was like, this thing you want to do, nobody else is doing. And I'm like, yeah, we out here. So for me, it's really important to be able to be like you're not on an island by yourself. There are creatives, like, storytelling was started and founded in Africa, so why can't we tell stories?
As many fans there are of the show, there's some critics and they're like, well, I don't see myself represented. And it's just speak to, like, the female black woman of it. If you don't see it, make it. Like, put that out there. That's like, if you right. don't see it, make it. There are enough platforms. This is an entire film crew, right?
Yeah.
And so what I'm so proud of is that Issa is doing that. Like, she's giving power to people to tell even more stories that aren't being told with her company. And she has a ton of projects in the works. And so that's why sort of, like, I'm hesitant to name names, because I want more names to be coming out.
Absolutely.
I want you guys to be creating the next. And so I can get at home, turn on my Netflix, turn on my platform, and watch your version of what it means to be a black woman.
Absolutely.
Hi.
Hey.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for coming. I think the first two seasons, we show them kind of living life and making lots of mistakes, and they're in their 20s, and so in some ways forgiving, but after a certain point you get to a point where it's like, you know better now. So what are you gonna do now that you know better? And this season we really wanted to just kind of set up those moments where it's like, you're on the right track, don't. This season, I was, like, drawing from experiences that I've had recently where, you know, someone's gonna be watching this show and be like, is this bitch? This just happened. This season has felt like we're really, like, on the pulse of what's happening now. Like, in watching it, you'll be like, oh, yeah, we were just talking about this, or this just happened, and that was just luck of the draw in terms of, like, things aligning with our schedule. But we don't aim to be super topical. We just want it to feel as real and as authentic and true as possible. Yeah, that's the advantage of running the show with someone who's also from LA. You know, Prentice grew up here. Prentice Penny, our showrunner. We love South LA, so just making that a priority for us was when he came on board. We always make sure to, like, reroute it to places that we know and that we know we go to. There are clues. He said it was Candace's idea to have an open marriage.
Right.
Obviously, there are rules, and so I think the gray area, which we love to live in our show, is what the rules of their relationship are. They are really in an open marriage. Yes and no.
Okay.
Is anything necessary? You know?
Yeah.
So.
That's deep.